separating the components of a mixture. Most of the natural substances are not chemically pure. Different methods of separation are used to get individual components from the mixture. Now, we are surrounded by so many substances around us. It is not a guarantee that all the substances that are surrounding us are pure substances. They might be mixtures also. A mixture is made up of two or more pure substances, right? Or they are made up of different type of a particle or different type of an atom. So we need to separate these substances. We need this individual substances. We need to isolate the pure substances. So for that, what do we need? We need to identify certain techniques so that we can obtain the pure substances from its mixture. And selection of method depends upon the nature of the components present in the mixture. In order to separate components of a mixture, single or a combination of methods are used. To separate a particular pure substance from its mixture, either we can use just one technique or a combination of technique has to be employed. And these techniques depend upon what is a substance that has to be separated. Now let's try to understand these various techniques one by one. First one is evaporation. Separation of volatile components from non-volatile components. This evaporation technique is used to separate volatile components. Now, what do I mean by these volatile components which can evaporate easily? So, we are trying to separate the volatile component from non-volatile component. That means that cannot evaporate easily. Now, look at this particular experiment. For this particular experiment, we need a beaker which is filled with water and a watch glass. Watch glass is an apparatus onto which a substance is kept. So here we are placing ink. And this whole setup is placed on a stand and there is a burner which supplies a heat. Here we cannot directly heat the ink because the ink might get decomposed and we might not get the desired result. That's why we are not heating the ink directly over here. If you notice, first we are taking beaker in the water and then slowly we are supplying the heat. We are not directly heating it. And the aim of this experiment is to separate the dye from the ink. Now, as we are supplying the heat to this particular beaker, we see that the energy is slowly being transferred to the watch glass. And as the energy is getting transferred, we see water over here, it is a volatile component, gets evaporated easily. Whereas a non-volatile component, that is my dye, it is left behind. The process of conversion of a substance from a liquid state to a gaseous state is known as my evaporation. Here in this ink, the solvent was water. The water got converted from liquid to the gaseous state and the dye was left behind. Another example for evaporation would be common salt from seawater can be separated by this method. We can take some seawater and put the seawater in a shallow pond and leave it. You will see that leave it in presence of sunlight for a long duration of time. We see that water gets evaporated, leaving the salt behind. This is another example for evaporation. Direct heating of ink is avoided as it may decompose on direct heating. Thank you. Let's try to understand chromatography. This is one more technique to separate the mixtures. Separation of components with the help of solvent. The term chromatography is based on the Greek word chroma, means color. See, this particular technique was first used to separate various colors. That's why the technique is also named after colors. That is, it is known as chromatography. This technique was first used for the separation of colors. It is the separation of those solutes that dissolve in the same solvent. Here we see a particular dye or a color is made up of many other different types of colors. Now the basic principle is, we are assuming that these solutes or these colors are all soluble in one particular solvent. It is the separation of those solutes that dissolve in the same solvent. The separation of different components of a mixture depend upon the different solubility in the solvent. This point will be clear when I'll explain this particular experiment to you. Now, separation of dyes present in ink by paper chromatography. Now, for this experiment, we need a chromatographic jar. We need a filter paper. We need a dye that has to be separated. Now, what we are doing is, we are placing just a spot of the dye onto the filter paper. Okay, first we are drawing a line, and in the center we are placing just placing a spot of the dye on the filter paper. Then we are taking this filter paper and placing it in the chromatographic jar, which has got water in it, and you know, slight bit of the filter paper is dipped over here in the water, very little bit of the filter paper, you know, the edge is touching the filter paper. Now what happens, this particular dye or the colors in the dye are soluble in this particular solvent. Okay, now as the water is moving up, here we see that the color that is readily soluble in water is carried farther. Okay, and then the next color that is soluble in water is carried, it is deposited below the first layer. Then it goes on. Now the color that is deposited closer to this line, it simply means that it is least soluble. It is least soluble. The one that is farther up or right at the top, that was highly soluble in water. So here we see different solutes or different colors are present in this particular dye. So all these dyes are being soluble in one particular solvent, that is water. And based on their solubility, they are carried at different levels and we obtain different colors. Now, what is the application of this? To separate colors in a dye, pigments from natural colors, it is used to separate, and drugs from blood. So this is the application of chromatography technique, and it is very important technique. Thank you.